So we were discussing about factors affecting BMR or RMR, and we have seen like age affects primarily BMR and RMR rate, and gender, men have higher BMR as compared to women, and body size also affect the BMR. As higher the body size, more will be the tissue and higher will be the BMR and RMR. Body composition such as muscle mass and fat, they also affects the BMR rate. Higher the fat and more calorie. Actually, muscle tissue uses more calorie than fat. Okay, and even at the resting situation also. So it will also depend on the body composition and genetic predisposition. Metabolic rate basically partly determined by genes too. Okay. And nowadays, gene responsible for obesity has been discovered recently. So it is also the genes of a person which determine the BMR rate. Growth, actually, growth also growth pattern of a individual or infant or children basically affect BMR. How? Infants and children, they have basically higher BMR and RMR related to energy needs of the growth and maintenance of the body temperature. Hormonal and nervous controls, basically hormones, hormonal imbalance influences BMR. Like you can see in case of thyroid, in hyperthyroidism, BMR rate increases abnormally, and in hypothyroidism, BMR rate decreases. So hormone also influences the BMR and RMR rate, and environmental temperature. If temperature is very low or very high, body has to work harder to maintain a normal temperature. So BMR rate increases in such situations. Infection and illness, they also affect BMR rate. Basically, during infection, BMR increases because body has to build new tissue or create an immune system to fight the infection. Crash diet, starving or fasting. Eating too few calories encourages the body to conserve through a potentially significant decrease in BMR. There can also be a loss of lean muscle tissue, which further contributes to reducing the BMR. So people who actually starve themselves for lowering their weight, and basically they their body usually retain more food as compared to those who are regularly eating food, and due to the disbalance in BMR rate. Also, physical activity affects the BMR rate. Hard working muscles require extra energy during activity, and regular exercise increases the muscle mass, which in turn increases the energy consumption even at rest. Some stimulants like caffeine basically increases the energy expenditure at rest. However, this is not a healthy way to lose weight. Okay. So these are all the factors which affect the BMR or RMR rate or energy expenditure of the body. What is the thermic effect of food? Okay. Thermic effect is the energy required to process the food we eat. Approximately 10% of calories in a meal are used to digest, metabolize and store the food just eaten. The energy expenditure is directly related to the size of the meal and food composition. Okay, so this is very simple, I think, because we all know that 10% of calorie in the food basically utilized to just digest and metabolize and storage purpose of food. Now, what is the energy expenditure of activity? Energy expenditure of activity is the amount of energy needed to fuel body movement as it occurs in activities of daily living, including exercise. Okay, like muscle tissue consumes approximately 20% of this energy at rest, but during vigorous exercise, the rate of energy consumption by muscle tissue may go up to 50 times or more. You can see During heavy physical activity or vigorous activity, the muscle may burn as many as 1200 calories per hour. So this is just the energy expenditure of activity. If we do vigorous activity, our muscles need more energy to do that activity. Okay, the cost of being sedentary. Actually, rising the rate of obesity are due to as much to reduce energy expenditure. Like for example, Canadian peoples, their physical activity level decreases. So and consumption of calories increases. So Canadian adolescents are spending more time on computers, playing video games and watching televisions than even before. Or okay, so basically those people who live sedentary lifestyle and eating sufficient amount of calories, they become obese, and this is the cost of being sedentary. And due to obesity, several other related disorders, they suffer from other disorders like cardiac disorders, diabetes, etc. So this is the basically something important to maintain a normal physical activity. Actually, moderate physical activity, 60 minutes a day, needs around 360 calorie. Okay, and vigorous physically activity, almost 30 minutes at the rate of 9 calorie per minute, needs 270 calorie. 30 minute, you can see here is the time difference. Therefore, the calorie difference is there. Okay, so remember this fact. And I've shown you in our syllabus that we should also know how we have to calculate our energy expenditure during physical activities. Like we can determine our resting metabolic rate, but we will cover this topic in the latter part of this lecture. Okay, so now coming to the a balanced diet portion, like what is actually a daily intake for an average person. Okay, the body, as you all know about, the body spends energy on various types of activities, and activity includes the movement we choose to do, as well as energy required to stay alive, like normal functioning of body, breathing, heartbeat, maintaining body temperature, etc. Okay, so energy requirement depend on age, gender, and body weight. For example, a 17-year-old female needs around 1350 calorie energy to sustain life, just to maintain its living daily resting requirement of energy. Okay, and if she do some physical activity, then she will need approximately 400 calorie more to maintain that level. Okay, so this is like active living is walking 5 minutes to school, coming back from the school, 3 minute walking in classroom, 15 minute walk at lunch, walking time, running time, 20 minute on treadmill. It will take only 316 calories. So total energy expenditure of a 17-year-old girl is 1350 calorie to maintain normal body physiological functioning, 400 calorie to maintain normal physical activity, and 316 calorie to maintain other tasks. So total 266 calorie per day. So if we want to plan a balanced diet chart for such a female, 17-year-old girl, so she should include in breakfast half plain bagel, 1 teaspoon peanut butter, 1 large banana, 1 cup milk. And if we calculate the energy of this diet, it would be 400 calories. In lunch, she can take slice pepperoni pizza, 1 cup chocolate milk, 1 granola bar, one small apple. So it will be equal to 607 calorie. And in dinner, she can take 2 cups of spaghetti with meatballs and tomato sauce, 200 gram garden salad with tea, 1 tablespoon oil, vinegar dressing, 1 cup milk, and cantaloupe. It would be equal to 777 calorie. And total, if we sum up all the calorie, including snacks, which includes cherry yogurt, chip cookies, chocolate chip cookies, the total energy expenditure would be 2100 calorie for a girl. It is for just Canadian person, not for Indian. Okay, I'm going to just show you the chart for Indian person too. Okay, so that's it for this topic. And now coming to the next, which I have shown earlier at the starting of this class, and this we are going to study from this note, the human energy requirement. We already cover few topics like what is the energy, and this is in context of India, and FAO, WHO, UNU also recommend the Indian ICMR guidelines for Indian people. Basically, RDA means recommended dietary allowances for Indians. Remember RDA? And this, as per RDA, we already learned about the basic concepts of energy and what what carbohydrate, fats, and proteins provide us during daily consumption. And we have also seen some terms like BMR or RMR, but we can just quickly see further the some few more terms like thermic effect of feeding. The food we have taken is just providing us the thermal energy, so it is known as the thermic effect of feeding. And there is also physical activity, which is the most variable after BMR, that is basal metabolic rate, is just the energy expenditure to maintain the body physiological processes. But physical activity needs higher energy as compared to BMR. And we will also see what are other factors which affect our energy requirement, daily human energy requirement. The first factor is growth. As the children is growing up, he or she should need more energy to for meeting his growing demand. Okay, for building his muscles, his bones, his overall organ development needs more energy. So growth affects the energy requirement, daily energy requirement. Pregnancy, during pregnancy, extra energy is needed for the growth of fetus, placenta, and various maternal tissues. And lactation also, lactating woman also needs extra energy to prepare milk, which is actually or for feeding purpose. And basically, the basal metabolic rate, thermic effect of food, energy or physical activity, and energy for physical activity, they are highlighted in this picture. You can see for a normal individual, BMR rate, that is basic metabolic rate, needs around 45 to 75% of energy from the food we have consumed. Thermic effect of food, thermogenesis, utilizes at least 10% of energy. And physical activity needs 15 to 50% of activity. It will depend on the level of physical activity carried out by a person. Okay, so these are basically energy distribution, how much energy one should require to maintain his BMR, thermogenesis, and physical activity. Factors affecting BMR we have seen earlier, so I'm not going to discuss it again, like body size, composition. Just quickly we will go through it: hormonal status, age, sex, and growth, disease, infection, and gender, hormonal activity, environmental conditions, pregnancy and lactation, fever, illness, infection, injury, and nutritional status, and some other factors. They affect the basic energy need of the body. So these are some factors, and we have already discussed it in our earlier topic. So I'm just quickly scrolled it down to move to the next topic, because it is too lengthy to finish it today, and I have to do it fast. We have to see this topic because it is important. What are the methods of estimation of energy expenditure and requirements? Okay. So these are the few methods. First is direct calorimetry, and second, indirect calorimetry. Third, factorial estimation. Fourth, the doubly labeled water technique. And the fifth is heart rate monitoring. Remember these techniques, they are very important to measure the energy expenditure of a person. Like in direct calorimetry, basically calorimetry refers to the measurement of amount of heat evolved or absorbed in a chemical reaction or change of state or formation of a solution. And calorimetry is a method by which we can monitor the amount of heat produced by a subject placed in a structure large enough to permit inordinate anion of activity. These structures are referred to as a whole room calorimeter. Okay, this method provides a measure of energy expended in the form of heat, but provides no information on the kind of fuel being oxidized. Okay, let me just tell you something very interesting. It is very primitive method to measure the BMR or daily energy requirement of a person by a direct calorimeter, where a person, when he or she woken up, he or she will be carried to a dark room where it is considered as a whole room calorimeter, where the amount of energy evolved from his or her body is calculated. Okay, evolved or taken up by his body. Okay, so that is why it is known as whole room calorimeter, and it will give us a rough idea how much energy in the form of heat is evolved from a person's body. Can you imagine? This can be possible. Okay, but this is very tedious and vague method to calculate the energy expenditure of a person. Another way to calculate the energy expenditure of a person is indirect calorimetry, where basically this method estimates the energy expenditure by determining the oxygen consumption and carbon dioxide production of the body or a cell over a given period of time. So we can calculate it using this formula. Respiratory quotient is equal to moles of carbon dioxide expire divided by moles of oxygen consumed. So respiratory quotient indicated the source of metabolic energy. Basically, it ranges from, actually, it is a well-known fact that RQ value for carbohydrate is 1, for fat is 0.7, and for mixed diet, it is around 0.85. So this basically determination is converted into kilocalories of heat produced per square meter of body surface area per hour, and it is extrapolated to energy expenditure in 24 hours. Like if a person breathing is controlled, like in 1 hour, he or she can take how many moles of oxygen, okay, how many moles of oxygen is taken by by a person, and how many moles of CO2 is expired by a person. If one can calculate it, okay, we can calculate how much energy he or she required during 24 hours using this formula. And another technique for measuring the energy expenditure is doubly labeled water technique. In this technique, basically, thermic energy of food is calculated. And for calculation of this, person is given a water enriched with stable isotope, either deuterium or heavy oxygen. H2 is deuterium. Okay, so it is known as doubly labeled. It is labeled with deuterium and heavy oxygen. Normal oxygen is oxygen 16. It is oxygen 18. It is isotope of oxygen. So doubly labeled water is given to a person for drinking, and total production of carbon dioxide is calculated. Okay, when a person is given a labeled water, he or she should exhale out the carbon dioxide, okay, over several days. Okay, so total energy expenditure was originally developed for use in small mammals like mice, for experimental purpose, and we can calculate it using these isotopic labeled techniques. So this is a very simple and direct estimation method for calculation of energy expenditure of human being or animals. Another method is heart rate monitoring method. Heart rate monitoring method is basically used to measure the daily energy expenditure of a free living individual based on the relationship of heart rate and oxygen consumption, and on minute by minute monitoring of heart rate. So people kept under the supervision, and his heart rate is measured using machine and oxygen consumption. And finally, they are put into the formula and we can calculate the energy expenditure. So these are all methods we have seen for the measurement of estimation of energy expenditure and requirement. And now moving to the next part, how one can estimate the total energy expenditure we have just seen. And we can also take it for example, like a personal care, eating, cooking, sleeping, sitting, household work, driving, walking, watching TV, how much energy one should need. Okay, like for sleeping, it should cost around 8 hours sleeping cost around 8 calorie energy. Okay, so sleeping also needs energy. And watching TV also need energy, but less than sleeping. Sleeping needs 8 and watching TV needs around 2.8. So this is all over the whatever activity we do, we need energy to perform that particular activity, whether it is sleeping or watching TV. You can see this chart to just find out the values. So now coming to the best, what are the daily requirement of dietary energy intake for a healthy human and different groups of person? Okay, so I'm not going in detail for all other groups, just you can see this for children, boys and girls. Okay, for children 1 to 3 years and 12 kg of body weight, they need 1240 kilocalorie per day. And for children 7 to 9 years of age who have 26 kg weight, they need 1650 kilocalorie per day. And like for girls and boys, I have shown you, like for 16 to 18 year girl having 49 kg body weight, they need around 2060 kilocalorie per day, and boys need 2640 kilocalorie per day. These are the recommended energy units as per ICMR guideline. And this is the basically boys' energy requirement in population with three levels of habitual physical activity. You can see, I'm just going to show you just the last, like boys around 17 to 18 year age, they should, if they perform light physical activity, they should take 2900 kilocalorie per day to meet their daily energy expenditure requirement. If they have around moderate physical activity, they should take 3400 calorie per day. And if they are heavily working, like their physical activity is more, they should take 3900 kilocalorie per day energy for their normal physiological processes and to maintaining their physical activity properly. And similarly for girls, you can see for 17 to 18 year age girl, I have already shown for light physical activity, they should take around 2100 kilocalorie per day. For medium activity, they should take 2500 kilocalorie per day. For heavy physical activity, girls should take 2800 kilocalorie per day diet. Energy requirements for adult man, for these body weight should it is depend on their sedentary, moderate or heavy workout regime. It should be 2400 for sedentary, moderate for 2800, and for heavy 3800. And for women, around for sedentary women, it is 1875 for moderate, 2200, and for heavily working women, the energy requirement should be 2900 kilocalorie per day. So remember this fact along with the body weight and normal physiological function. These are the daily average energy requirement for men aged 18 to 29.9 years. Okay, so you should take like what should be the energy requirement and particular BMR for an average person belonging to this age group. And this is also a daily requirement for female. This chart is daily requirement for men aged between 30 to 59.9 years of age. And this chart is for daily average energy requirement for women aged 18 to 29.9 years of, okay. So as per their BMR, they need their body energy requirement varies, okay. So you can see the chart and learn any one value, whatever you feel good, okay. And this is the energy requirement for women having age around 30 to 59.9 years. And this is for men. You can see this chart and learn whatever you know. I am moving to the next important fact, which is asked in many exams, like energy requirement during pregnancy. Okay, as we have seen that a normal healthy female should take around 2000 to 2500 energy kilocalorie per day, but for a pregnant woman during first trimester, he or she should take plus 85 kilocalorie apart from those. And second trimester, she should take 300 kilocalorie per day extra energy apart from the daily need. And during third trimester, she can continue the diet of excess energy. And this is recommended by ICMR. For WHO, FAO, and UNU guideline, it is around plus 85, plus 285, and plus 475 kilocalorie per day. Energy requirement during lactation. Lactating women should take 550 kilocalorie per day extra energy apart from his basic need during first 6 months of lactation. And afterwards, if she continues feeding, she should take extra 440 kilocalorie per day energy apart from his basic need. Apart from her basic needs. So remember this fact, these are very important and they can be asked in competitive exams. So you should know about this. What are the energy imbalance? Energy imbalance leads to various defects like lower energy, like negative energy balance. Would lead to muscle devastation, weakness, etc. And positive energy balance would lead to obesity and cardiac or health risk or diabetes, etc. So one should maintain the energy need of the body, like height and weight ratio should be maintained properly. Body mass index we can calculate by weight. Weight in kg divided by height in square and chondral index and Vance index is weight by height in P. P is the Vance index, power of Vance index, and weight always here weight we can take in kg. So this is the recommended. I have shown it you earlier in our earlier class. Underweight people should have less than 18 kg per meter square BMI. Normal range people, people's BMI ranges between 18.5 to 24.9 kg per meter square. And overweight people have should be lying between 25 to 29.9 kg per meter square. And obesity can be categorized on the basis of this BMI in class 1, class 2, and class 3. Where class 3 people have BMI more than 40 kg per meter square and they are considered as a very critical severe situation as per WHO. And so this is all about your BMI and weight grading and overall about whatever in our syllabus. I have sum up this. You can ask any question if you have, or we will continue this topic if you want. Like I'm going to just take a pause here.